Okay, so we are in live right now. Hello everyone. I hope you guys are doing wonderful. This is Satish here. So today I came up with a new topic, Karaka of different events in Vedic astrology. So ideally, we'll be coming across different events in our life, right? So it can be marriage, it can be foreign settlements, it can be making a lot of money or getting a government job or some kind of celebration at home, or it can be even the traveling, it can be starting up a business, it can be purchasing some kind of gadgets. For each and every event of the life, there is certain planet associated for it. So today I'll be discussing to you about different events in Vedic astrology. Okay, starting with the planet Sun, and I'm super excited to share this information. The reason being, once you understand the different karakatvas of different karakatvas of events in Vedic astrology, you can able to relate anything in this life with the planetary system. All right, so it will become very easily for you to understand in terms of how astrology is being governed across different events in your life. All right, so once you know which event is being governed by which planet. So once you see your own birth chart, you can able to recognize why that event has happened and why and which planet has created that kind of problem or that kind of blessing in your life can be predicted by knowing the Karakatvas in Vedic astrology. So that's why this topic is very, very important. So this will helps you to understand different events in the life, which I'll be telling it to you across the different slides. All right. So thank you so much for joining everyone across different platforms. And let's get into the slides quickly. All right. Okay, starting with planet Sun. Okay, so basically, Sun, as you guys know, Sun Karakatvas are basically, it can be about your father. Any event about your father can be seen from the planet Sun in your birth chart, depending upon even the relationship with your father, how your father progress will be with regards to you, can be seen from your own birth chart with the placement of planet Sun. Let's say if Sun is sitting in the positive state, okay, then the things related to politics and also government and all this success in a short span of time. Some people will become successful entrepreneurs by the age of 20, 25. And the degrees also matters. It's not about just the planet should be friendly or non-friendly. The degrees at which Sun is sitting in your birth chart also plays a major role. So you have to analyze the situation in such a way that you need to analyze the degrees that Sun is sitting and also which nakshatra the Sun is sitting. Which nakshatra the Lord of Sun is setting also matters a lot, and most importantly, aspects also matters a lot upon planet Sun. Okay, so if you ask me about the Karakas of Sun, Sun represents government, Sun represents politics, Sun represents the development and expansion in your business, in your personal growth, or in the professional growth, or in the business growth. For that, the Karaka is Sun, and Sun represents name and fame as well. Sun gives you a lot of very good reputation in the society. So people will respect you for your knowledge, wisdom, and the virtues that you're. Okay. Sun represents the brightness as well. Let's say you're among 100 people, but your name will be always highlighting. For the Karaka is basically Sun. So Sun is considered as most important planet. If you have very good placement of Sun in the birth chart, then you will be successful at a very younger age. With a less effort, you'll become successful. So that's what it says. All right. Planet. So let's see about Moon. Okay. Moon represents your mother. And Moon, the Karakatvas of Moon are basically your mind, your thought process, your understanding, your conflict management, the way you understand other people's feelings and emotions also will be governed by planet Moon. Okay, and Moon represents the elder sister as well. Moon represents liquids, the liquid-based business. Okay, Moon represents the traveling. Moon represents the blames, cheating. All these things happens if you have a negative Moon in the horoscope. Losses, business losses, are great losses. If you have Moon in the 12th house, that leads to a lot of losses and expenses. and too much of expenditure. Expenditure is being governed by planet Moon, right? So, and adultery. Adultery also comes under planet Moon. And changes. Some people will be having job changes, mood swings, or, you know, moving from one place to another place. All these things are governed by planet Moon. Moon represents the cold weather as well. And Moon represents the water. The water intake in your body can also will be governed by planet Moon. Okay, Moon is very important because Moon, the Karakas of Moon is basically a mind. Once you have a proper mindset, then you can able to deal with any kind of challenges. So for that, the Moon's energy is really required for you because this planet governs your mind and thought process. All right. So if you have a negative Moon, the negative traits which I've told you, all those things gonna be happening. For that also, Karaka is basically a Moon. Okay, let's talk about Mars. Let's talk about Mars. All right, so let's talk about Mars. Yeah, Mars is basically a fire planet, element of fire. Okay, Mars represents the body, Mars represents the husband, and Mars represents the younger brothers. The younger brothers in your life is being governed by planet Mars. And Mars represents technology. If you want to have advancement in the technology career, if you want to have very good name and fame in the technology, you need to have strong Mars in the horoscope. Okay. And the missionaries, all this civil engineering, missionaries, okay, and rivalry, disputes, you know, the quarrelsome nature, argumentative, I'm talking about the negative Mars now. Quarrelsome nature, disputes, arguments, you know, anger, showing up your attitude and ego on somebody, all these things are governed by planet Mars. Okay. And Mars represents the willpower, the energy, the passion. Okay. And Mars represents the adamancy nature as well. Some people are very adamant. You know, they don't want to listen to anybody. They just have their own principles in their life. Okay. So, and also these are all governed by planet Mars. And accidents is being governed by planet Mars. Because why? Because the Karaka for blood is basically Mars. Right, so these are all the Karakatvas of basically planet Mars. Depending upon strong Mars or weaker Mars, or Mars has been aspected by different planets, your prediction will be changing. All right, so let's talk about planet Mercury. All right, what is planet Mercury? Mercury represents intellect, your creativity, your knowledge. Mercury represents the management skills, your leadership qualities, the way you'll be acting as a leader to and standing as an example to other people, also being governed by planet Mercury. Mercury represents your communication, okay, your analytical skills, your logical skills, your creative skills, your strategical management. All these things are governed by planet Mercury, okay? And Mercury also represents the support from the friends. If you have very good support from the friends, then it means that you are having a strong Mercury. And also, of course, depends upon the degrees at which Mercury is sitting. For some person, Mercury will be sitting at 12 degrees. For some person, Mercury will be sitting at 25 degrees. For some person, Mercury will be sitting at 0.7 degrees or something. So we have to see the planetary strength of you need to analyze the strength of the planet in your birth chart before giving the final prediction. So that's why the overall chart has to be analyzed. Okay, so basically these are the Karakatvas of Mercury. Mercury represents even the business as well. In order to have a business mindset, you should be having Mercury's blessings as well in your horoscope. Okay, and Mercury represents philosophical knowledge as well. Some people get into the philosophical debates and everything. For all those things, Mercury also is the Karakatva. And Mercury represents diplomacy. Some people are very diplomatic in nature. Okay, they'll be doing a lot of cross-examination, you know, doing a lot of research and all that. A lot of correspondence, all that stuff, that is all being governed by planet Mercury. All right, so Mercury is very, very important planet for business especially. Okay, so let's talk about planet Jupiter. All right, so Jupiter is considered as the most auspicious planet of all nine planets. If you have a strong Jupiter in your horoscope, then you will not have any kind of crisis with regards to money. Maybe here and there, some kind of ups and downs will be there depending upon the transits of Jupiter and also aspects that Jupiter is receiving. But let me tell you, Jupiter is considered as the most auspicious planet. So that's the reason if any malefic planet, if at all any negative planet that you have, and Jupiter is watching that negative planetary system in your birth chart, then the negative effects are cancelled. So then you can imagine how powerful is Jupiter. Only Jupiter has that capability or capacity. And some part of it even Venus is having. But Jupiter takes a first rank in terms of eliminating the negative effects of other planets. Let's say if Rahu or Ketu is troubling you in your birth chart as per the negative element in the birth chart, then if Jupiter is watching that Rahu and Ketu, then the negative effects of Rahu and Ketu are reduced. So that much powerful is. And that is the reason Jupiter is considered as a Karaka for expansion. If at all you want to have growth in your personal life, professional life, or business life, you need to have a Jupiter's blessing. Jupiter is a Karaka for money. Jupiter is Karaka for wealth. Okay. Jupiter is also the Karaka for marriage and relatives. Okay. Respect in the society. And the Jupiter takes the lead role in terms of managing the entire education industry. Entire education industry is under his control. Because Jupiter is all about wisdom, knowledge, understanding that true knowledge. Okay. You can able to listen to your inner voice, you can able to connect to your intuition. All those things happens because of Jupiter's blessings in the horoscope. Okay. And Jupiter is a Karaka for male. In female birth chart, Jupiter represents the husband. If at all you want to see the characteristics of husband in the female birth chart, you have to analyze the planet Jupiter in the birth chart. And Jupiter represents the judge. Jupiter represents discipline. Jupiter represents development, as I mentioned to you. Jupiter represents the growth. Jupiter represents respect. And Jupiter also provides you that pathway to understand God as well. It is not that easy subject. A lot of people who are believing in God, in order to get belief on God and to get the blessings of God, you got to have a Jupiter blessings. You should be having the Jupiter's energy in a good state in your horoscope. With proper Jupiter in your horoscope, you can able to reach out to great mentors in the life. If Jupiter is negative, you'll be coming across the fake mentors who will be misguiding you, who will be, telling you the wrong things. Okay. All those things happens if you have a negative Jupiter. And a lot of people undergo losses by subscribing to a lot of courses which is not related to them. That is also happens if you have a negative Jupiter. You'll be going across the things which are not required in your life. Okay. So Jupiter's blessings is really, really very important. And in fact, Jupiter is considered as the most auspicious planet in the Vedic astrology. Okay. So let's talk about other planets. Yeah. Let's talk about Venus. Okay. Venus is the Karaka of female. In the male's birth chart, the support from the female, the respect from the females, and the relationship with the female figures, all those things can be seen from the Venus placement in the male's birth chart. In the female birth chart, Venus represents her own self. Okay. So Venus represents sister. Venus represents daughter. Venus represents daughter-in-law. Venus represents luxuries. Venus as well. And especially the rank one I can give in terms of wealth is to Venus. Because Venus is considered as the most important planet. The financial stability in your life can be seen from the placement of Venus in your birth chart. Venus represents wealth, assets. Venus represents vehicles. Venus represents the real estate profits. Venus represents the construction industry. All those things are governed by planet Venus. If at all you have very good Venus, you'll be with a lot of luxuries. By birth, you'll be having a lot of luxuries. You'll be in the very rich family. And most importantly, even your connections also will be very influential people. You'll be connecting with the people are of very higher authorities and all that. A top management support will be there if you have strong Venus in your birth chart. All right. So let's talk about planet Saturn. Saturn is basically a very hard teacher. He will teach you the lessons in a harder way by putting you into a lot of tests, by giving you a lot of challenges, and he will see how you can overcome those challenges. With those in the process of dealing with that challenges, he will teach you a great lessons as well. He will teach you the great lessons. Once you learn that lessons, then he will start giving you whatever it is required for you. It can be money, it can be good job, it can be very good business profits, it can be name and fame, it can be foreign settlements, it can be anything, whatever you wish for, Saturn will be able to provide. Provided, will be provided to you. Provided if you fulfill all the obligations or the tests that is being Saturn is creating to you in your birth chart. And this happens depending upon the Saturn's placement in your birth chart. And Saturn also is a karaka for, Saturn also governs your Sadesati. A Sadesati is the seven and a half tough period of planet Saturn, and it happens across for all the people. This is basically to just mold you into a good individual, to teach you certain lessons. All right, Saturn is a karaka for elder brother as well. Saturn is the karaka for career. If you want to see the career pursuit, the career prospects in your birth chart, I have to analyze the placement of planet Saturn in your birth chart. What are the aspects Saturn is receiving? What are the degrees that Saturn is sitting? What is the nakshatra that Saturn is owning? All those things is being governed by planet Saturn. And Saturn represents the slowness. If you have strong Saturn in your birth chart, let's say if Saturn is in your lagna, in the first house, then it will be very slower. You'll be very slow, you'll be very lazy. Saturn represents laziness as well. Some people are very tired, they'll be always feel like sleeping, they don't like to do anything, they don't like to show interest. For all those people, they have weak Saturn in the birth chart, or Saturn is being afflicted by Ketu or Rahu or some malefic planet like Mars and all that. So we have to see the placement of Saturn, the degrees of Saturn, the conjunctions of Saturn it is hitting the birth chart, what are the aspects that Saturn is receiving. All those things should be analyzed thoroughly. Okay. And Saturn also represents conflicts nature as well. Arguments, conflicts, debates, losses, tiredness, laziness, blames. All those things represents planet Saturn. Okay. If you have a good Saturn, then obviously things will turn out to be a positive. If you have a bad Saturn, things will turn out to be a negative, which you need to learn the lessons from it. And you have to do certain remedies to come out of those things. All right. So let's talk about planet Rahu. Okay. Everybody fears of planet Rahu. The reason being, Rahu creates that illusion around you. He will create illusion around you and get the things done out of you. Once you do the things, you'll repent for why you have done that. That kind of attitude will be given by planet Rahu and Ketu, of course, in the birth chart. Okay. Rahu represents your paternal grandfather. Rahu represents the foreign country. Some people like to go to foreign countries and all that. They want to settle in foreign countries or to do studies in foreign countries. For all those things, you need to have blessings from planet Rahu, okay? And Saturn Rahu represents corruption as well. Rahu represents hard work. Rahu represents accidents. Mainly accidents happens because of planet Rahu. If you have affliction of Rahu with Jupiter or with Mars, you'll be prone to a lot of accidents in your birth chart. And Rahu represents the surgeries, operations as well. Even Mars represents surgeries. Rahu also represents operations, surgeries, you know? And Rahu represents the multimedia. Rahu represents mass communication, mass figures, multi, everything. If you, wherever you see multi and many, all those things are big. All these words represents planet Rahu, where Rahu energy should be added, because Rahu have the capability of amplifying the things. Let's say if Rahu sits next to Mercury, he will amplify the energy of Mercury. If Rahu sits along, he will amplify the energy of Mars. So all those things should be analyzed. And Rahu also is there for time management. In order to maintain proper time management, you need to have lessons of planet Rahu. Okay. And Rahu gives that passion and zeal to achieve lot many things in your life. A lot of people frame their goals. Let's say for 2020, you would have framed lot many goals. So that passion to achieve, that zeal to achieve, that energy that is required for you to achieve all those goals that you have formulated, you have designed in your diary, for all those things, in order to fulfill all those goals, Rahu's energy is required for you. That is the reason Rahu, although being a malefic planet, it is there in your birth chart as well. He will be playing his own role in terms of providing you some ups and downs in your life. Okay, and we need to analyze it based upon the Rahu's placement in your birth chart, of course. And let's talk about planet Ketu. Okay. Ketu represents the maternal grandfathers. Okay. Ketu represents law, your litigation, your medicals, medical field, medical pharma, litigation, obstacles. All those things were being governed by planet Ketu. And Ketu represents misunderstanding, difference of opinions. K Ketu represents the careless attitude. Ketu represents spirituality, enlightenment. Ketu represents imprisonment, jails, and CBI rides and all that. All those stuff, IT rides, all those things happens because of affliction, afflicted Ketu in your birth chart. For all those, and Ketu represents, Ketu represents the diseases as well. The kind of skin diseases that you get, and also some kind of gastric troubles. All those things happens because of planet Ketu. Okay, Ketu does good things and bad things as well. Ketu is based depending upon the placement, especially Rahu as well. So Rahu and Ketu will not do only bad things. Please come out of that confusion. Rahu also capable of giving you enormous money, which no other planet can able to give. Similarly, Ketu can also able to provide. Provided Rahu Ketu provide good vibes around you and good things in your life. If Rahu and Ketu are situated in your third house, sixth house, eighth house, and 12th house only. Okay. Our Rahu should be receiving, Rahu and Ketu should be receiving the aspect from Jupiter or Venus. Then the things will change again in your positive state. Okay. Let's say Rahu and Ketu are sitting in the first house, second house, fourth house, fifth house, seventh house, ninth house, 10th house. 10th house Rahu is good. Ketu is not good. And 11th house. Rahu Ketu doesn't work well. Okay, they'll be giving the negative events in your life for which you need to do the remedy for planet Rahu and Ketu. Most of the tough sudden events happens because of planet Rahu's affliction in your birth chart. The sudden bad events happens because of Rahu's affliction in your birth chart. So these are basically different karakatvas in Vedic astrology. Once you understand what planet is giving which event, who is the Karaka for certain event in the Vedic astrology, it is very easy for you to analyze your own birth chart. All right. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any questions, please put it in the comment box. I really love to answer for that. And that's it for today. Thank you so much, guys. And bye for now. We'll come up with another topic in Vedic astrology. All right. Bye for now.